Hey guys, welcome back in TypeScript 5 for Absolute Beginner series. In lecture 4 of this series, we will try to understand the arrays, tuples and enums in TypeScript. In this lecture, we'll cover introduction to arrays, working with tuples, enums and common array operations. First, let's discuss arrays. Arrays in TypeScript are essential tools for holding multiple values together, making them ideal for managing lists or groups of similar data. Let's see a coding example to see how we can create arrays in TypeScript. Let numArray, here I have defined my array's name, colon type of array. Type of array is number. Now these parentheses will define that this declaration is for array. If I want to initialize my array here, then I can initialize it like this, equal parenthesis 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is my num array. This array is of number type, and in this array we have four numbers, 1, 2, 3, and 4. We can also have string array like this. We also can create our array with another method in which we create the object, like let numArray1 colon array, it's a keyword, then parenthesis, here I need to define the type of my array, equal all the number type elements. One thing you need to remember here is that array's length in TypeScript can be increased or decreased because it's dynamic. Next, let's talk about tuples. In TypeScript, tuples let you store a fixed number of elements with various types in one variable, similar to arrays but with a set structure. Let's create a tuple of type person. Okay, one good thing about the tuple is they allow each element in the array to be a known type of value. Like here I'm going to define first element type string, second element type string again, and the third element should be number. One more thing is tuples are of fixed size. Now against these types I'm going to define its values. First will be John, as you can see it's a string type. Second is date of birth 10/09/2001. Then last is his age, which must be a type of number, and it's 21. Now let's print our tuple. You can print it like this, console.log. Person 0. Now this person 0, this will print 0 index value. Person 1 will print second index value, and person 2 will print the third index value. Now if we see the difference between both arrays and tuples, then typically a tuple is an array with fixed size and known data types. Let's print it. As you can see, it printed all the indexes, name, age, and date of birth. Next, let's explore enums. Enums in TypeScript let you define a group of related constants with clear names, making your code more readable and organized by offering distinct values for variables. First, let's define an enum, enum direction. Now the name of my enum is direction. Next, I'm going to write a group of constants in this enum, up, down, left, and right. So these are the direction I want to use in this direction enum. Now by default, the index of this up element will be 0. If I want that my all the elements value will start from 1 index, then I will change this up index to 1. According to this first index value, now down index value will be 2, left index value will be 3, and right index value will be 4. It is also possible to define the values of all indexes in an enum explicitly. Also in TypeScript, it is possible to define an enum with string values, which is not commonly spotted in most other programming languages. Let's see its example. Enum direction str up is equal. Now by default its value is numeric, but we can change it to string, and this is the way we can define our string type enum. Now how we can use this enums? For example, here I define a variable var left of type direction, and I want to store direction.left value in it. Exactly like this, we can store our string type enums in a variable. But in this case, it will store the string type value in this left str variable. Let's print it and see its output. As you can see, first variable have number value and second variable have string type value, which is left. So this is the way enums work in our TypeScript 5. Next, let's talk about common array operations. For the addition of elements, we use push and unshift. And for removing elements, we use pop, shift and splice. For finding an element, we use index of find, find index. And for the sake of iteration through the array, we use for each, map, filter, reduce. And for the sorting and reversing, we use sort and reverse functions. Then for the combining and slicing arrays, we use concat and slice. Now let's explore all these functions in a coding example. First, let's see unshift. And unshift adds one or more elements to the front of an array and returns the new length of the array. So our array updated like this. Next, if we want to add one or more elements to the end of an array and returns the new length of the array, then we will use push function. Let's execute it and see how our array is updated now. If we analyze this array in output window, then we can see this first element added by unshift function and sixth element is added by push function. Next, let's see all the functions which remove the elements from the array. Now if I want to remove the element from end of the array, then I will use pop. What pop function will do? Pop function will remove the last element from an array and returns the element. Now if I want to remove the element from the start of array, then I will use this shift function. Shift function will remove the first element from an array and returns that element. But if I want to remove the element from middle of the array, neither from the start nor from the end, then I will use this splice function. What this splice function will do, it will remove the element from an array, like let splice equal num array dot splice 1 start from first index, and how many elements I want to remove, 2. Now let's print all these values separately. Let's run the application. In output window, you can see in pop we have 6, in shift we have 1. And after removing 1 and 6, our array having 4 elements, 2, 3, 4 and 5. And then we splice first index, and after first index we have to delete 2 elements, which are 3 and 4. So it removes 3 and 4 elements. At the end, it prints the complete array, which is have only 2 elements, 2 and 5. Next, let's see finding elements. First, we have index of function. This will return the index of an element within the array equal to the specified value, or minus 1 if none is found. Then we have find function. In find function, we use lambda expression. Like here, I'm writing x implies x greater than 3. So it will return 4 value to us. Then we have a function findIndex. Now this function will return the value of index according to the specified condition. Like here I'm having x implies x greater than 3. So it will return the value of index. Like x greater than 3 have 4 value, and 4 value index is 3. So it will return 3. Let's print them to see the output. First, it print the index of 2, which was 1. Then it prints minus 1 because we don't have an index 7. Then we print 4 because here we have to print our specific value, which is greater than 3. Then at last we have to print the index of the value, which is 4. So this is the way these finding functions work. Next we have few iteration functions. First we have foreach function. This foreach function calls a function for each element in the array. Next we have map function. This map function creates a new array with modified values. Then we have filter function. This filter function creates a new array with all of the elements of this array for which the filtering function returns true. Then we have reduce function. This reduce function apply a function simultaneously against two values of the array from left to right as to reduce it to a single value. Now in reduce, this total variable will have previous value and num variable will have current value. In this reduce function, we will add both these values, previous and current. Now let's print the result of all these iterative functions. Now this all iterative function will not modify our original array, but they will create new array with modified values. So these all are showing the output as expected. Next we have sort and reverse function. Now this sort function will sort all the elements of this array and it will sort the array in ascending order. Then we have reverse function. This reverse function reverses the order of the elements of an array. The first becomes the last and the last becomes the first. Next we have different kind of functions for combining and slicing an array. Let's see them one by one. First there is concat function. This concat function will return a new array comprised of this array joined with another array or other value. Then we have slice function. This slice function extracts a section of an array and returns a new array. Now it will slice all the values from 1 to 4. Let's print it and see the result of these all functions. As you can see, the output window show all the expected output of these all functions. And this is it for today. Hope you understand the entire lecture. If you have any query or question, you can ask in comments. And stay connected for further lectures of this series. If this lecture is helpful for you, then please guys like, subscribe and share my channel. Thanks for watching.